So after discussing on different streams of careers like mathematics, medicine, and economics, in this session, we are going to discuss about the career in information technology. So let's start. We are the part of the most connected society of all time. The amount of interaction we have with computer systems in our daily lives has grown dramatically over the last few years, particularly with the younger generation spending more time on computers. This was because of the tremendous impact the information technology had on the world. In fact, information technology has touched almost every aspect of our lives. So, what is information technology? As we all know that a computer system consists of hardware and software. Information technology deals with computer software by doing many automatic operations related to the storage of data, control of the data, transmitting the data, retrieval of the data, and even installing various applications. Some of the famous personalities are education, eligibility. You should be passionate about computers and computer-related subjects. In general, you need to be good in a computer subjects from your childhood. Or it is advisable that you choose information technology or computer science as your undergraduate course. Some of the undergraduate courses are B.Tech in Information Technology or B.Sc. in Information Technology. One can also enter into IT field by mastering several courses that are required to get a ticket into a plane of IT sector, irrespective of the branch in the graduation. Like even if you do a mechanical or civil or metallurgy, any engineering course, if you want to go into IT field, you can master several courses in 1 year, then you can get an IT job. After your undergraduation, you can get into some of the MNCs like Microsoft, Google, Accenture, IBM, Infosys, TCS, HCL, etc. So after undergraduation, if you do not go for a job, then you can go for M.Tech by writing GATE examination. If you get a good score, you'll be getting an M.Tech seat in IITs or NITs. And a good thing is opportunities in PSUs also. We know that opportunities in PSUs are less for computer science or information technology students. These are some of the PSUs which recruit computer science engineers. After M.Tech, you can go into teaching field, start your career as an assistant professor. Some colleges might accept GATE score for getting into the teaching field, but there is an exam UGC NET which is conducted by NTA. Through this, you can get lectureship, or most importantly, you can go into the research side also as JRF. JRF is Junior Research Fellowship. So keep a note of UGC NET conducted by NTA. The interesting one, career, salary and lifestyle. There will be different careers in the field of information technology. You can be a data engineer, data scientist, UI developer, DevOps engineer. The growth when compared to other sectors or other jobs is very high, and the salary for a fresher in IT industry might vary from 10,000 rupees to 1 lakh. This variation is due to the skill which the student has, the college from which he passed out, the software languages he knows, and the internships which he has completed. These are the related careers. The highlights and challenges are: the growth rate when compared to other jobs is high. Increase in salary will be good. And if you're passionate about working in IT, then you can charge yourself with the improvements in technology year by year. These are the other highlights. Some of the challenges are chances of health hazards due to continuous sitting. Another challenge is irregular working hours. Sometimes if the project deadlines are not met, or if it is a new project which is in development phase, then you need to work for long hours. And you need to work during weekends also. There might be a time where you need to work 1 or 2 months in a stretch to meet the deadlines. These are the various certifications in IT sector. Some of the top programming languages are What are the skills developed? Good coding skills, teamwork, problem solving skills, and most importantly, if you're working in an IT field, you'll develop your communication skills. Coming to the future scope,
software is required everywhere, from banks to hospitals, and even almost all our day-to-day household activities are getting automated. As the future will be more into automation and artificial intelligence, so choosing information technology and its related careers will be a very good option.
The entrepreneurial opportunities are, you can start an IT consulting firm, you can start your own IT company which is both product and service based, or you can start a teaching institute and teach some software courses like Java, SQL, C, C++, Python. You can take inspiration from Facebook and start something related to social networking. You can start your digital marketing firms. And the interesting thing, these days people learn very well by spending 1 hour daily as private online tutors. And the last but not the least, you can start your cryptography company also. Thank you. With this, we end this session. In the next session, we'll be coming up with another interesting video. Thank you.